Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about two types of word problems today. One is finding the dimensions of a rectangle, and the other one's comparing two different entities. In the first one, the length of a rectangle is 5 less than twice the width. The perimeter is 32 feet. Find the dimensions. What we have to do is decide what we're going to call the width and what we're going to call the length. I'm going to call the width W. Since this is 5 less than twice the width, this is twice the width, 2w. 5 less than that is minus 5. You cannot put 5 minus 2w. It's the width that we're taking away from, so it has to be 2w minus 5. If I put that into my rectangle has a width of w and a length of 2w minus 5. Remember the perimeter formula is 2l plus 2w for a rectangle. So I'm going to take 2 times my length, which is 2w minus 5, and 2 times my width, which is w. Another way is just to write 2w minus 5 twice and write w twice, and then just add all 4 sides. That would work as well. In this way, though, I'm going to distribute and get 4w minus 10 plus 2w. 4w and 2w is 6w. And then I'm going to add 10 to both sides. When I add 10, it goes away over here on the right. Adding 10 to 32 gives me 42. And then divide both sides by 6 gives me 7. W is my width, so my width is 7. How did I get my length is 9? I took 2 times 7, which is 14, and then subtracted 5 to get 9. All right, the second type of word problem, comparing two entities. In this problem, Adolfo bought a $60 phone plan, which included 8 gigabytes of data. On the 20th day of the billing cycle, he received the following message from Verizon. You've used about 90% of your 8 gigs of data. Cycle ends on the 6th. Extra data for the cycle will be $15 for 1 gigabyte. Or to increase your plan by 2 gigabytes for $10 more per month, reply yes. So Adolfo knows he will need about 3.5 more gigabytes of data this month. So he's gone 90% of 8 is about 7.2, and he's going to go 3.5. So he's going to get pretty close to 11. And because of his current project, he will also need to use about 11 gigs of data for the next few months. After that, his data usage will drop back down to his usual rate of about 7 gigs per month, and then he won't be going over. If he moves up to the 10 gigabyte plan, he will have to pay that rate for 1 year. How many months could his project cause him to go over before it's cheaper to go up to the new plan? So if it was just this month, it'd be cheaper to stay with his current plan, but how long can he go without doing that? So what you want to think about is his current plan. He's going to have 3 extra gigabytes per month. So it's $60 a month for 12 months. That's his current plan. But then he's going to pay for 3 extra gigabytes of data, which is 3 times 15, which is going to be 45, which we get down here. And that's for X number of months. We're not sure how long. If he went up to the new plan, he would still need 1 extra gigabyte because the new plan gives him 2 extras. But he needs 3 extras, so he would pay then $70 a month for 12 months, plus he'd have to buy 1 extra gigabyte of data for those same amount of months. That 1 times 15 times X is where I get 15X. So what we want to know is, when would the old plan be equal to the new plan? The old plan is less than or equal to the new plan. Once it becomes greater than, then we just want to switch, right? So 60 times 12 is where I got 720, 3 times 15 gives me 45, and then 70 times 12 is 840 plus the 15x. So what I did was subtract 15x from both sides. That makes it go away on the right. 45 minus 15 gives me 30, and then I subtracted 720 from both sides. 840 minus 720 is how I got the 120. Then divide both sides by 30, and that will give you X is less than or equal to 4. And that means that after 4 months of going over by 3 for his current plan, it would be equal. So at 4 months, it would be exactly equal. So if Adolfo knows he'll only go over for a few months, 1 2 or even 3 months, he should stick with his current plan. If he's going to go over for more than that, he might as well switch to the higher gigabyte plan. All right, have a fantastic day, and we'll see you next time.